God, thank you so much for this opportunity. God, you are the father to the fatherless, and you care more for teens who are in care than any of us ever will. And so, God, we just need more of your heart, and we need those who will be on the other side of the camera to have more of that heart as well. So, God, I just pray that you would allow us to think about who you are and to think about your gospel and to think about the need that is presented before us, and that we would encourage and equip others to join you in your work to father the fatherless. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We became foster parents about 8.5 years ago when we adopted our three youngest children from the foster system. God really led us to enter the process again to adopt a child. And we started the process thinking that we would adopt another sibling group younger than our youngest children at the time. And so we were introduced to the Bair Foundation and started through the classes and started through the process. It was really exciting to go through the classes the second time with the gospel being not only a topic that could be discussed, but that was central to learning how to parent these children and learning how to care for youth that are in care.
We also went in thinking we were going to adopt another sibling group younger than our children that we had, the three that we had adopted. We watched a video of this sibling group, ages 3 and 5, and they're really cute, and we were excited, you know. We're like, yeah, we'd love to adopt them, you know. And I remember her saying, like, okay, well, there's 4 or 5 other families that are interested in this sibling group. So we just were like, what? Why are we looking at them if there's, you know, there's families interested in this group? So, you know, we asked her, where are the kids that there's nobody interested in? Like, can you show us some kids that need to be adopted where no one's wanting to adopt them right now? So she pulled out a big binder, and I remember we flipped through the binder, and it was teenager after teenager after teenager, and I knew right then that we were going to be adopting a teenager because it was such a need, and my heart just broke for all the teenagers in that binder. That was God's plan for us, was to adopt Danny.
I thought that I was going to age out because I was 11, and nobody wants an 11-year-old to be in their house with them.
If I were not adopted by my mom and dad, I think my life would be totally different. So this is really personal, but it's really true. I think I'd probably be a teen mom. And I would probably have aborted my child. My life has changed dramatically. I've grown so much in Christ that the history and the past that I know I had, I don't really feel like I've had it. And I feel like I've been here all my life, even though I know I haven't. I have a lot of hopes. I want to be a social worker because I want to help kids get homes. But I want to be like an adoptive social worker. If I was to talk to someone becoming a foster parent, I would say, you need to stick it through. It's going to be hard at first, but in the long run, it's worth it.